हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ रेजिस्टेंसेस। सो रेजिस्टेंसेस आर कम्बाइंड इन टू वेज, दैट इज सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन एंड पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन, एंड देयर इज अ मिक्स्ड कॉम्बिनेशन आल्सो, दैट इज द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सीरीज एंड पैरेलल, बट बेसिकली देयर आर टू, सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन एंड पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन। सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन। सो इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशंस the resistances are joined end to end, and in this case current will be same, voltage will be different. Why? As you can see here, three resistances of resistance R1, R2 and R3 are connected in series combination. So you can see that the first end of the R1 resistance is connected with the positive terminal of the cell, and the second end is connected to the first end of R2. Similarly, the second end of R2 is connected to the first end of R3, and R3 second end is connected to the negative terminal of the cell. So in this case, you can see that there is an end-to-end combination. Now, if you see, if current I will flow, so there will be only one path for the current to flow. So therefore, current will be same across all three resistances, but voltage will be divided. So across R1 if we take V1, R2 if we take V2, and R3 if we take V3, then we will find out what will be the equivalent resistance. How we will find out? Using Ohm's law. So before that, description of this figure. So in figure, three resistance wires of resistances R1, R2 and R3 respectively are connected in series. Let the equivalent resistance of the three resistances be R. If we take that equivalent resistance of these three resistors be R. Now suppose a current I is flowing in all the three resistors. Also suppose V1, V2 and V3 be the potential difference between the ends of the resistances R1, R2 and R3 respectively, then by Ohm's law we have V1 is equal to IR1, V2 is equal to IR2 and V3 is equal to IR3. So if the potential difference between A and B across this end be V, so we can write V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, and putting the value of V1, V2, V3 will get IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. You can see I is common, so we can take it out. So what we will get? V is equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now the equivalent resistance we have taken as R, so V is equal to IR. Now comparing these two equations, will get IR is equal to IR1 plus R2 plus R3. II will cancel out. You will get R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So what we can say, that the equivalent resistance of the resistances connected in series is equal to the sum of the individual resistances. As you can see, R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now second is your parallel combination. So in this parallel combination, the first end of all the resistances are connected to one point and the second ends are connected to other point. Now in this case, voltage will be same and current will be different. Why? Because all end of the three resistances are connected to one point, and this side all three ends are connected to one point. So because of that, the potential will be same across all these three resistors. But when the current I will flow, so there will be three paths of the current to flow. So current will be divided. So therefore, we can say that current will be different. If we take I1 across R1, I2 across R2 and I3 across R3. Clear? So again, a description of figure. In figure, three resistances R1, R2 and R3 respectively are connected in parallel combination. Let I current is flowing from the cell, then current through R1, R2 and R3 be I1, I2 and I3 respectively. Let the potential difference between A and B is V. Again, using Ohm's law, here we'll get I1 is equal to V by R1, I2 is equal to V by R2, I3 is equal to V by R3, because V is same. Now, if the net current flowing through the circuit is I, so we have I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Putting the value of I1, I2, I3, what you will get? V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. You can see that V is common. We can take it out. Also, if the equivalent resistance between the two point A and B be R, In that case, I will become equal to V by R. And comparing these two equation, we can get V by R is equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. V will cancel out. You will get 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So we can say that is the reciprocal of the equivalent resistances of the resistances connected in parallel is equal to the sum of the reciprocal of the individual resistances. As you can see, 1 by R will be equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is a easy topic and an important topic. Sometime it is asked to prove this in series combination R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Like the question will be given, like prove in series combination the equivalent resistance is equal to the sum of the individual resistances. So very easily you can prove. Just you have to keep in mind, in series combination what will be same? Current will be same, voltage will be different. And also for that, you remember that there is only one path for the flow of current, so therefore current will be same and voltage will be different. In parallel combination, keep in mind, because there are three paths for the flow of current, so in this case current will be different and voltage will be same, then very easily you can use the Ohm's law to prove that. I hope that is clear to you. And then we have many of the numerical based on the combination to find the equivalent resistance is asked. So when we discuss the numerical, we will discuss few of the questions related to this topic. Now the next topic that we are going to discuss is effect of temperature on resistivity. So again, a very important topic. From this topic also, not a 3 mark question will be asked, but definitely 1 or 2 mark question you will get, or one numerical you will get based on this formula. So what will be the effect of temperature on resistivity also, on resistance also? So because we had discussed that when the temperature will rise, there will be change in the resistance as well as resistivity. So one by one we will discuss what will be its effect on the conductor, on alloys, on semiconductor, electrolyte. So one by one we'll discuss. So first we are going to discuss about the resistivity of metals. So metals are good conductors, so you can understand this, that this is for conductor or for metals. So in this case of metals, for resistivity, with the increase in temperature of a metallic wire, its resistance increases. So how it increases? And also we can say that the resistivity of the material of the wire increases. So how we can say that? That with the increase in temperature, the resistance or the resistivity increases. So for that, we need to discuss this formula. We had studied about the formula R is equal to M upon N E square tau L by A, where we had also say that M upon N E square tau is your resistivity. This is your resistivity and this is your resistance. So here we can say that R is equal to rho L by A. Clear? So now coming to this point, R is equal to M upon N E square tau L by A. So what is M here? M is the mass of the electron. What is N here? N is the free electron density. That means number of electrons per unit volume. E is your electronic charge. Tau is your relaxation time, average relaxation time. L is the length of the conductor and A is the area. Now think about what are the factors that will not change with the increase in temperature and what are the factors that will change with the increase in temperature. So you can see that M, which is the mass of the electron, so that will be fixed, that will not change. Length of the conductor, or if you say, if you are taking metallic wire, so length will also will not change. Area of cross section will also not change. Charge on the electron will also not change. What will change is N, that is number of electrons per unit volume. Clear? Also, what will change will be the average relaxation time. Now, how they are connected with resistance? So you can see that R is inversely proportional to tau, and R is also inversely proportional to N. Is it so? Also, you can see that rho is also inversely proportional to N, and rho is also inversely proportional to tau. So similarly, we can say that if resistance will increase, then resistivity also increase. So in this case, R is inversely proportional to tau and inversely proportional to N. That is the number of electrons per unit volume or free electron density. We say this one as free electron density also. Now, what is tau? Tau is the average relaxation time. Now, in case when we increase the temperature, first you know what is relaxation time. So it is the temperature between the two the time duration between the two successive collision. The time between the two successive collision is known as relaxation time. Like an electron when collide with a positive ion, and then when it goes to collide with the second positive ion, this duration will be your relaxation time. Is it so? Between two successive collision, the time duration, that will be your relaxation time. The time that the electron get to relax, that is your relaxation time. And if we consider, because inside the conductor there are large number of electrons, free electrons, so if we take tau for all these, so average will be the average relaxation time. Now when you increase the temperature, so when we increase the temperature, what will happen? The vibration of the electron will increase. So because of that, there will be more collision and fast collision between the electron and the positive ion, and due to which this time will start decreasing. Is it so? The relaxation time, that means the time between the two successive collision will start decreasing. They will collide with each other very fast. So because of that, tau value will start decreasing. So when tau will start decreasing, so that means R will start increasing. So that's why we say that when the temperature will rise, tau will decrease. This value will start decreasing, and when this value will start decreasing, so that means R will start increasing. So R value will increase when the temperature will increase. Is it clear? So this is the first factor. Now coming to the second factor, number of electrons per unit. In that case, when we increase the temperatures, though in that case more number of electrons will come out, and there will be a large number of free electrons. So if we say that in this case when we increase the temperature, so in that case number of electrons will also increase per unit volume. But in case of conductor, we know that the number of free electrons were already in very large number. So in this case, we consider that this factor is not very dominant in comparison to this factor of tau. Is it clear? The factor of increasing the number of electrons per unit volume in comparison to the factor of tau is very dominant. This factor is dominant over this factor. Is it clear? So this factor dominate this factor, and because of this we say that when the resistivity will increase, when tau will decrease, the resistance will increase, and therefore the resistivity will also increase. So out of all this topic, this discussion, you when sometime it is asked to give the reason, so reason will be given very easily by this formula. That's why this formula is very important. If you know this formula, then you can very easily discuss about the resistivity or the resistance. Clear? So that's how we can say that with the increase in temperature, the average relaxation time start decreasing, due to which the resistance will increase and the resistivity will also increase. So this is what it is written here. With the increase in temperature of a metallic wire, its resistance increases, that is the resistivity of the material of the wire increases. And in other words, with the rise in temperature, the electric conductance of the wire decreases. What is conductance? It is the reciprocal of resistance. So when the resistance will increase, obviously the conductance will decrease. Now, if the resistance of the wire at 0 degree Celsius be R naught and at T degree Celsius be RT, then we know the relation, this relation RT is equal to R naught 1 plus alpha T. There is a derivation of this equation, but this is not in your course, so that's why you need to learn only the formula. So, this is the formula relating the resistance at T temperature to the resistance at 0 degree Celsius. So, RT is equal to R naught 1 plus alpha T, where alpha is your temperature coefficient of resistance. So, if we solve this equation, so for alpha, so alpha will become equal to RT minus R naught upon R naught into T, and its unit will be per degree Celsius because T is in denominator. So this is a very important formula. Derivation is not important, only the formula is important. So we have alpha is equal to RT minus R naught upon R naught into T. This formula you need to learn because questions sometime will be asked to find the temperature coefficient, and you will be provided the resistance at 0 degree Celsius, at T degree Celsius. Temperature is given to you, so you can easily find the value of alpha. Now consider if R naught at 0 degree Celsius, the resistance is 1 ohm and temperature is 1 degree Celsius. So we can say that alpha will become equal to, when this value will become equal to 1, alpha will become equal to RT minus R naught, and that will be equal to the increase in temperature. Now for most of the metals, the value of alpha is nearly 1 upon 273 times per degree Celsius. So in this case, if in place of alpha we put 1 upon 273, what will get? RT is equal to R naught 1 plus T upon 273. So R naught will become equal to 273 plus T upon 273, and 273 plus T we can write it as capital T, which is your absolute temperature. So, RT will become equal to R naught T upon 273, where T is your absolute temperature, and therefore we can say that the resistance will increase with the absolute temperature. Now, here you can see if we plot a graph for copper, if we are plotting a graph between the resistivity and the temperature, so the graph will be something like this. So, in the start it will be non-linear and afterward it becomes linear. So it is clear that for several metals, rho is inversely proportional to temperature, but in reality there is always a non-linear region at very low temperature. Here this region is non-linear and afterward it becomes linear. So at very low temperature, rho tends to rho naught near the absolute zero. So it will not start from here for copper, it will start somewhere from here. Now next is your for resistivity of alloys. So the resistivity of alloys also increases with the increase in temperature, but this increase is smaller in compared to the pure metals. So in the metal, the resistance or the resistivity increases very fast with the increase in temperature, but in case of alloys, that is small in comparison to the pure metals. So this is only you can see the graph for if we take nichrome. So for nichrome you can see this graph. Nichrome has a very large resistivity even at 0 degree Kelvin. So this is called the residual resistivity. Nichrome, that resistivity it has at 0 Kelvin, this resistivity is your residual resistivity. Now coming to resistivity of semiconductor. Most of the time in board this question is asked about the semiconductor. What will be the effect of resistivity on semiconductor? So first you need to know that what is semiconductor. So semiconductors are the substance which whose conductivity lies between the conductors and the insulator. That means its conductivity is more than insulator but less than conductor. Is it clear? So insulator does not have number of, means it does not or nearly zero free electrons. Conductor have a very large number of free electrons. So that means semiconductor will have the number of free electrons in between insulator and conductor. So in conductor the charge carrier is your free electron, but in case of semiconductors the charge carriers are electrons as well as holes. So electron, holes and semiconductor will study in the electronics chapter afterward. But for here, you need to know that what is semiconductor. So semiconductor whose conductivity lies between conductor and insulator. Now the resistivity or the resistance of the semiconductor decreases rapidly with the rise in temperature as shown in figure. So resistivity of the semiconductor decreases with the rise in temperature. For conductor it increases, but for the semiconductor it decreases with the rise in temperature, and therefore it has negative temperature coefficient of resistance. So germanium or silicon is a semiconductor, so in that case the graph will be a decreasing graph between rho and T. Now why it decreases with the rapidly rise in temperature? So coming to again this that we had just now discussed about this one. So in this case of, this is the case of semiconductor in which the this factor of relaxation time is dominant over the factor of number of electrons per unit volume. But in case of semiconductor, the rise in the number of electrons will, the factor of rise in the number of electron per unit volume is dominant over the relaxation time, and due to which it's number of electrons is dominant, so that means the number of electrons will increase. In that case the R value will decrease. Is it clear? So in that case number of electrons per unit volume will increase, and due to which the resistance will decrease. So you can say that for semiconductors, number of electrons per unit volume increases, therefore the R value decreases. And why the number of electron? Because it has less number of free electron in comparison to conductor, first thing. And second, it when we consider about the conductor, so they have a doping. Intrinsic conductor are the pure form of semiconductor, but what is used in the electronic circuit is the impure form of semiconductor, in which there is some impurity added to it. And that process of adding impurity is known as doping. So all that is we will discuss in detail. But for here, since they have the impurity atom also added in, so therefore when the temperature will rise, the number of free electron rises very frequently in this case. And because of that, this number of electron per unit volume increases, and therefore R decreases, and this factor will become irrelevant in comparison. The factor of tau. Is it clear? So therefore in this case of semiconductor, with the increase in temperature the resistance decreases, and therefore it has a negative temperature coefficient of resistance, because when you find RT minus R0, so it will come negative. So because of that we have the negative temperature coefficient of resistance. Now last is your about the resistivity of the electrolytes. So the resistivity of the electrolytes also decreases with the rise in temperature. The reason is that when the temperature rises, the viscosity decreases. I hope all of you know about viscosity. So the viscosity of the electrolytes decreases, and therefore the ion gets more freedom to move inside the electrolytes, and therefore the resistance or the resistivity of electrolytes also decreases. So this is the topic of effect of temperature on resistivity. The two important one is about you need to know is the resistivity of the metals, and most of the cases in the examination it is asked for the resistivity of semiconductors. And remember, to give the explanation you have to go through this formula, you need to learn, and by this formula you can easily say that R is depending on N. And also keep in mind that N is not number of electron, it is free electron density, number of electrons per unit volume, and tau is your average relaxation time. If you know this, then very easily you can explain this topic. So the now our this chapter 5 is over. In the next lecture I will discuss the numerical, and I hope you are completing the notes, because soon I will check your notes. Thank you.